Today, we will visualize breadth first search on an undirected graph. Before we start, let me introduce you to undirected edges. An undirected edge is an edge between two nodes such that both nodes can travel between each other in a bidirectional fashion. A directed edge means that a node can only travel one way but not the other. So you can think of an undirected edge as just two directed edges for each direction. Now, what is a graph? A graph is just a series of nodes connected by an edge. The edges could be directed or undirected. One way to represent the graph is using an adjacency list. An adjacency list is a mapping of nodes to its connected neighbors. You can implement this as a map with the key being a node and the value being a list of nodes that are connected. So here we have a graph on the right and its corresponding adjacency list on the left. Now let us go over the algorithm for breadth-first search. The idea of breadth-first search is that we want to search all of our immediate neighbors first, and then all of their immediate neighbors, and repeat until all nodes have been visited. To do this, we need to keep track of all the neighbors we want to visit, as well as all of the neighbors we have already visited to avoid revisiting them again. Hence, we will use a queue and a set. We mark our starting node as visited by adding it to the set and also push it to the queue. While the queue is not empty, we pop the node from the front of the queue. At this point, we can also do further processing on the node if we wish to do so. Afterwards, we look at our graph, which is represented by an adjacency list, to see if it has any neighbors. We can see that 1 has 4 neighbors, 2, 3, 4, 5. We mark them as visited and add them to our queue in no particular order. Now that we have finished pushing all the neighbors of 1 into the queue, we can proceed to pop the next node of the queue, which is 2, and start searching for its neighbors. Since 2 only has 1 neighbor and it has been visited, we move on to the next node in the queue, which is 5. We see that 5 only has 1 neighbor, the node 6, so we will mark 6 as visited and add it to the queue. We then move on to the next node in the queue, which is 4. We see that 4 has 1 neighbor, the node 7, so we mark 7 as visited and add it to the queue. Then we move on to the node 3, which has no non-visited neighbors. The same case applies for node 6 as well. At node 7, we see that we have a new neighbor, 8, that is non-visited, so we mark it as visited and push it into the queue. At the end, our queue is empty, which means that we have searched through all of the nodes in the graph. Take a look at our visitor set, which is ordered by the time visited in this simulation. Notice how the nodes 2, 3, 4, 5 are searched before nodes 6 and 7, which are searched before node 8. This is because nodes 2, 3, 4, 5 are one edge away from our starting node 1. Nodes 6 and 7 are 2 edges away, and node 8 is 3 edges away. The key idea behind breadth-first search is to search the closest neighbors before expanding to the next set of neighbors. Hopefully this visualization was able to demonstrate that. If you like this video, please make sure to like and subscribe. Thanks.